not talking about a couple of punches here. I am talking about the tag team belts, the championship, and the new champion, Strike Force. Tito Santana and Rick Martel put their collective efforts together, and it proved to be much too much for the Hart Foundation. Now, Strike Force was, of course, a top contender, so this was not a major upset. What was surprising, though, was the maneuver used in the victory.
Meanwhile, Santana sent the hitman reeling. Ooh, down to the midsection.
Look at this double team.
All right.
That's right.
Slam. Santana gets out of there. Martel trying to get him over.
Boston Crab submission.
Martel from Canada, Santana from Mexico, and wouldn't you know it, they used the Boston Crab to get the victory. All right, I talked to them in a delirious locker room moments after the win.
How does it feel?
It's a great moment for the Strike Force. You know, like my partner said, it was a real tough match, and we beat the tough team there. So, you know, they say winning it is one thing, but holding on to it is another. But we're ready for it. We're ready for it.
So, Strike Force is the new tag team champion, and if they go by that saying, you dance with the girl you took to the prom, I would think we'll be seeing frequent use of that very impressive Boston Crab. With Update, I'm Craig DeGeorge.
No, not that.
Had a chance right after that match to talk to Tito Santana and Rick Martel, and they told me that they had heard a rumor that the Anvil did, in fact, have a bad lower back, and they went to work on it. Obviously, the rumor was true, right,
Frank? I need party hats.
Oh.
Yeah,
he doesn't have a clue what we're doing here. You know what we're doing. You know what's
you're
coming up next.
I picked up everything. You're talking about the Anvil giving up. You know what happened there.
What's coming next? You don't know, do you?
I know exactly what's coming next.
Tell him. Go ahead.
Just one moment.
you don't know, do you?
I know exactly.
You should know. It's a special interview with your team.
Hulk Hogan's team will take on the team I have with me right now, led by the managers, the Doctor of Style, Slick. And, of course, the Brain, Bobby Heenan.
You know, when you look around, you wonder how anybody can survive getting in the ring with the natural Butch Reed, King Kong Bundy, the one-man gang, ravishing Rick Rude. I'm in one corner, he's in the other corner, and captained by this man, the eighth wonder of the world, and next heavyweight champion, Andre the Giant. But there's something I think everybody should see. You see, after Hogan gets through hiding behind the likes of Orndorff and the likes of Patera and Bam Bam and his other partner, then he is going to have to step in that ring. Hogan, that 300-pound blonde turkey, is going to have to step in that ring. And eventually, he's going to have his hands full with Andre the Giant. But let me show you a little something. I happen to have a nice little toy here. It's the brand new Hulk Hogan stretch doll. Now watch, what happens if the natural grabbed an arm? And let's say, Bundy took this arm. And then what happened if the one-man gang grabbed a leg? Well, what if ravishing Rick Rude grabbed the other leg? What would be left to grab?
Showing much respect for the heavyweight champion.
You know why? Because what you see assembled here is a congregation of sophistication, brother. And when it all boils down to that, these men are going to destroy that Hulk Hogan and those bombs.
You know what he's going to look like? You know what he's going to look like?
We'll find out on Thanksgiving evening.
Well, you thought it was funny, didn't you?
Yeah.
Between you and the Slickster, there's going to be so much dissension on that team.
No. We've had a meeting. And there's a big meeting in 2 days.
Well, you're only 1 week away from the event.
I know, but we're
Richfield Coliseum. All roads will be pointing there. If you're not there inside the Richfield Coliseum, you'll be amongst the millions who'll be watching on over 400 pay-per-view cable systems. Let's take a look at Hulk's team.
Now, you can tell what that team's saying right there. Orndorff is saying, how are we going to protect Hogan? Superstar says, I don't have an idea. Bam Bam Bigelow says, Who's Hulk Hogan? Patera says, I'm just glad to be out in the streets. I don't want to make license plates anymore.
Will you stop? Why don't you be realistic for once
That's
in your
happening.
Life?
That's what's happening.
Take a look at your team. I'll give you the weight advantage.
Okay.
Over 1 ton inside.
We've got nothing to lose, though. We don't have a championship at stake. Neither do they. But if Hogan was injured and he couldn't defend that title, he could be stripped of it.
They've got three former champions. One world's heavyweight champion and two former. Superstar Billy Graham, former world's champion.
Yes.
And
Ken Patera.
Intercontinental
right.
title holder, Kenny Patera.
And he's also a former ex-con.
Let's take a look at another captain and his team.
Oh, I look at that. The Honky Tonk Man, probably the greatest intercontinental champion in the history of wrestling.
He must have laid awake at night thinking of putting together that congregation.
Oh, no. Dangerous Danny Davis. Man, not only is a great wrestler, but used to referee. The outlaw Ron Bass with Betsy the Bullwhip. And the people that I have went to the team. The King, Harley Race, and Hercules.
They're in a lot of trouble. I got news for you. They're in a whole lot of trouble. Coming up this coming Thursday night, Thanksgiving night, Richfield Coliseum, the big one. Those were the golden tones of Vince McMahon. I don't know why you're so enthralled about Stand Back. They had to bring back a lot of unhappy memories seeing that footage. Earlier on in the program.
Wait a minute.
I asked you folks to get a pencil and paper who, in fact, had that dish sitting out in your backyard or up on your roof.
Ring area, he will be led by his manager, the Doctor of Style, Slick. And from Kansas City, Missouri, weighing 255 pounds, the natural Butch Reed.
Oh, man, that music is too much. That's Jive Soul Bro. It's Jive, all right. I don't know if it's Jive Soul Bro or not.
His opponent, from Paradise Valley,
Nation superstar, Billy Graham.
What an ovation. Look at this capacity crowd. All standing in appreciation for the superstar.
Oh,
come on.
I'll tell you what, ovations don't win you matches. That's for sure.
Read all over superstar Billy Graham.
He didn't even let the superstar get into the ring before he nailed him.
Maybe it was a breakthrough. Maybe he figured if he gave him a fair chance, it might mean trouble for Reed, huh, Jesse?
That might be true, Bruno, but you do whatever works.
Oh, baloney. This is disgusting. Let the man in the ring and be a man and start the match properly.
Natural Butch Reed just hammering away.
You know, you're a fine one to talk about that, Bruno. I remember when you jumped Billy Graham the same way.
And look at this.
All over his hip.
That's right.
Why not?
Why not?
He knows it's a weak spot. He knows it's
a minute. Look at that.
He knows that's his Achilles heel. If Graham can't take it, he shouldn't be in there.
What do you mean if he can't take it?
Wait a minute.
What a chair. Who could?
Come on. The slickster distracting the referee.
You know what this shows me? This shows me that Slick and Reed were prepared when they came into that ring, and Billy Graham was not.
The Slickster, not much in the way of a managership, many say, but the one-man gang high on the Slickster, just as the natural Butch Reed is. Here's what the gang had to say.
There's a lot of bad rap going down on the Slickster. Will you people lighten up on the Slickster, because he's the greatest manager in professional wrestling right now. I believe that, and the natural believes that, and he's promised us to take us all the way to the top in the WWF.
All the way to the top, huh?
You know, the interesting thing about this match so far is superstar Billy Graham has showed virtually no offense whatsoever.
That's true.
None.
Oh, wait a minute! Superstar! Look at that! Right across the... Oh, wait a minute! Oh, yeah!
Hey! Now, he had no reason to bring Slick into the ring.
What was Slick doing on the apron? He doesn't belong on the apron. Go ahead. Should pick him up and throw him over those top ropes. Teach him a lesson once and for all.
Get it!
Come on, Billy, hit him!
He's a manager. What do you mean, hit him?
Hit him! He deserves it. He's always interfering.
Superstar Bearhead! Oh! Gang coming in, sending the Slickster.
This shows me right here, you want to mess with the manager, then you're going to pay for it. Because there's a lot of loyalty in wrestling between wrestlers and their managers.
What are they doing to him? Oh, no, got across the hip.
Right on that hip, too, right on the bad hip. Look at that. 400 and some odd pounds. Look at
that. Oh, my goodness. What are they trying to do to him?
I'll tell you what they're doing. They're going to end this career. That's what they're trying to do.
They're going to send him back to the doctor again. You mean to tell me we're going to have to watch one of those bloody operations?
Oh, coming in!
Let Morocco go.
That was in Morocco cleaning house in there. We saw him earlier on. Morocco out there with Reed. And the long man gang.
Billy Graham's hurt.
Better believe he's hurt with what he took on that bad hip.
Well, he shouldn't be in there then. If he's
what
not
do you mean he should be in there? The man attacked him with a chair and everything else.
Oh, come on! Come on now! I can't believe what he just did.
He dropped that superstar Billy Graham right out on the floor. And the problem for Morocco is there's just too many of them.
We'll be back.
The nightmare continues for superstar Billy Graham. What an onslaught. Only because The Rock came out there to the rescue. There's no telling exactly how bad superstar is.
You know, the most important thing is, I don't know who cares.
I'll tell you who cares. A lot of people care. I care for one, and we're gonna take you right now and show you some additional footage from that particular match.
Happy trail.
Superstar Billy Graham unable to get to his feet, had to literally be carried out of there on a stretcher. Let's take a look at it.
Oh, my heart.
Look at him writhing in pain, superstar Billy Graham. We're taking him out. We may have seen the last of the superstar. What an ovation for this man, though. What a gallant effort.
I believe the gang and Butch Reed have given Billy Graham mandatory retirement.
Superstar on a stretcher.
The body said mandatory retirement. That may indeed be the case. Perhaps world's heavyweight champion Hulk Hogan better look for another member of his team.